must say, we have one of the most attractive audiences we've ever had in for Pop Quiz tonight. For the two teams skippered by Dave Gilmore and Ian Gillan, both back for their fourth time, so it's a real needle match, this one. Firstly, to Ian's team, and they are from The Alarm, who's flown all the way down from Rill, Mike Peters. And certainly the smartest-dressed man here tonight, Alan Price. And their skipper, just back from the States and claims he knows nothing about the last year at all, which could, same could be said for any year, Ian Gillan. And they're going to be battling it out against Dave Gilmore's team, who are from Swansway, Maggie. We tried to persuade them all to wear those dresses, but they wouldn't. From Modern Romance, Michael Mullins. And the ex-Pink Floyd man, Dave Gilmore is the skipper. So an individual round to start with. I'm going to play each of you a middle eight from a well-known song, and I'd like you to tell me both the song and the artist that the middle eight belongs to. Mike, you're first to go. Here comes yours. Not easy.
Well, it's either Heroes or Go Buddy Go. The Stranglers, isn't it?
The Stranglers is right. What's the track you're going for?
No More Heroes Anymore.
I'll give you 1 point out of two. It's actually Hanging Around.
Hanging Around, yeah.
Hanging Around. So 1 out of 2 for you. Maggie, here's yours. Good.
That's Your Love Is King. Sade.
By Sade. 2 points. Well done. Ian, this middle eight for you. Great mime. What's the answer?
Diddling ding doing ding ding. It's Johnny Kidd and the Pirates Shaking All Over.
Shaking All Over, Johnny Kidd and the Pirates. Tell you what, I'll give you a bonus point if you can tell me the name of the guitarist that's playing that.
Guitarist? Yeah. Mickey Green.
Mick Green is absolutely right for a bonus point. Well done. Right, one for you, Dave. See how you do with this one. And Valerie. I'll give you a bonus point if you can tell me who had a hit single with a song called Valerie in the 60s. No. It was the Monkees. Actually, the Monkees had a big hit with that. But 2 points, no bonus, but 2 points for that. Well done. Alan, your turn. Where does this middle eight come from?
No idea.
Are you going to say that by the look on your face?
I'm getting a hint here, but I can't.
You can't lip read.
I can't lip read. Yeah. The Allman Brothers. He says it's the Allman Brothers.
It was a little too blatant, even for this show. I mean, it was the Allman Brothers and Jessica. Oh, actually, it's Mike's writing. It's absolutely appalling.
Yes, I
must. However, nothing there. But Michael, one for you. What's this? In the same way that it's easy at home, Alan now has his hand up saying, I can answer that one. But Michael, it is?
Layla, Derek and the Dominoes.
Layla, Derek and the Dominoes. 2 points, well done. So at the end of round one, Ian Gillan's team 4, Dave Gilmore's team 6. Round two is a video round, right? You'll see three videos and hear three songs, but the videos and the songs don't match up. They're three totally different songs that don't belong to the videos. You get 1 point each for recognising the three videos and 1 point each for recognising the three songs. Ian, your three videos coming up first. Seem to fit so well as well. Three videos and three totally different songs. Do you have any idea what they were?
Yeah.
Good.
But I'm not telling you. No, I think we've got most of them. The first one was Altered Images, the track going with that was Cyndi Lauper.
Do you know what the Altered Images song was?
Happy Birthday.
Right. And you have fun.
Yeah. 2 points so far.
The second video was Vienna.
Mm-hmm.
And the soundtrack was Visage, wasn't it?
Yeah,
Fade to Grey.
And Vienna Ultravox, yes, 4 points. And
the third video was Men Without Heads.
Hats.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, Mike's writing is appalling, I know, yeah.
And I couldn't catch the track.
Safety dance, it was.
Didn't really know what the song was.
No, not
so you got 5 out of 6, which is great. Nick Kershaw, When Let the Sun Go Down on Me, was the one that's been playing, which fitted so well to Men Without Hats, so I thought. 5 out of 6, anyway, well done. Good stuff. Right, Dave, let's see if your team can get 5 out of 6 with these three videos and these three songs. I like the way he does that dance when he got four. You know it really blows my mind. Three videos, three songs.
First one is, I think, Malcolm McLaren, Buffalo Girls,
mm-hmm.
with Break Dance, Street Dance.
Break Dance is the song, isn't it? Break Machine, right.
Yes.
The second one is Bonnie Tyler singing Total Eclipse of the Heart,
mm-hmm.
with Kim Carnes, Betty Davis Eyes, very subtle.
Right.
Van Halen's Jump Over the ZZ Top Legs video, was it?
What was the title of the track?
Was it Legs? Was it the one
for? No? It's Sharp Dressed Man.
Sharp Dressed Man.
So 5 out of 6, which is also good stuff. So at the end of round 2, Ian Gillan's team 9, Dave Gilmore's team 11. Our exuberant crowd applaud for the dreaded lyric round, which is next, which is round 3. Maggie, your lyric coming up. Bad day when you wake up and you find out your dream's blown away. Bad day when you wake up and find out your dream's blown away.
Yeah, Bad Day by Carmel.
Bad Day by Carmel. No problem. Right, Michael, has 2 lines for you. This is the first time until today that you have run away. I'm asking you for the first time. Don't really know if I can stay.
I'm going to close.
It topped the charts back in 1968. This is the first time I'm dealing. The Equals with Eddie Grant back in 1968, the chart topper Baby Come Back. Right, Dave, where did these lines come from? For you, I've been aware of the time going by. They say, in the end, it's the wink of an eye.
The Pretender Jackson Brown.
Pretender Jackson Brown, no trouble at all. And I thought that was going to be a tough one. Right, Ian, your lyrics are as follows. That jukebox in the corner blasting out my favourite song. The nights are getting warmer, it won't be long. No Oscars for the reading, but that jukebox in the corner blasting out my favourite song, the nights are getting warmer, it won't be long.
I don't know. Sounds like, I mean, Chuck Berry was right about
Sorry?
Jukeboxes. Chuck Berry?
It sounds more like Thin Lizzy.
Whatever you say. That jukebox in the corner blasting out my favourite song, the nights are getting
warmer, it won't be long till summer comes. Thin Lizzy and the boys are back in town. Right, Michael, have a look at these two lines. No first of spring, no song to sing. In fact, it's just another ordinary day.
I haven't got a clue.
Oh, the audience were bursting.
It's not one of them, is it?
I heard them whispering. Stevie Wonder, they were whispering. No first of spring, no song to sing. In fact, they're always the most difficult, the current records.
One, is it?
Sorry?
Is that an old one?
It's an old one, yeah, it's an old Stevie Wonder track. I just called to say I love you. Right, that was the current number one, so no points there. Lastly in this round, Alan, some lyrics for you. If they think they're better than him, they're wrong. So I went to the park and I took some paper along, and that's where I made this song.
Rednecks Randy Newman.
Rednecks Randy Newman. Whoa! Right, Ian Gillan's team at the end of round three have 11 points. Dave Gilmour's team, 15. Right, team round coming up. You can confer, but it's skippers only with fingers on the buzzers. You're going to see a video of a well-known pop legend going back to doing what they used to do before they do what they do now. And also a piece of music running backwards. You get 2 points for guessing the person, 2 points for guessing the track, and don't give me the answer until the end, and then we'll see whether you've guessed this person correctly. Yes, Ian Gillan's team. Who do you think the person
was? Well, we thought
was?
It was Captain Sensible. I'd say it was and Captain, we were under the impression that it was one of his songs. And we thought it was Happy Talk. So.
I'll tell you whether you're right or not in a moment.
Okay.
Did you have any thoughts on that, Dave?
We had some, but they weren't correct.
Maybe thought it might be Edwin Collins from Orange Juice, but
Let's see who it was and what the song was. The first picture of you, the first picture of summer, seeing the flowers scream their joy. Very embarrassed having to wear a moustache. Nick Heywood there enjoying himself doing a spot of artistic work. It was Nick Heywood and the Lotus Eaters' first picture of you. So no points for anybody. And at the end of that round, it's still Ian Gillan's team 11, Dave Gilmour's team 15. Right. Individual round coming up, starting with you, Mike, a clip of the Great Jam singing That's Entertainment.
Watching the telly and thinking back.
such a holiday. That's entertainment. That's entertainment.
Right, the Jam, and that's entertainment. For 1 point, Mike, can you name any two Jam albums?
Two Jam on Sound Effects.
Sound Effects.
Setting Suns.
And Setting Suns, that's two. Well done, 1 point. And for the other point, which Curtis Mayfield song did the Jam record?
Move On Up.
Move On Up, yes, for the other point. Well done. You have 2 points for that, Maggie. Let's see if you can get two with Roxy Music. Virginia Plain, 1977. Can you name the member of Roxy Music who wrote the score for the TV series Rock Follies?
Yeah, Andy Mackay.
Andy Mackay it was, for 1 point. And for the other point, can you name Roxy's only number one hit?
Their early one.
Their only number one
only
hit.
Number one. Oh, it was that John Lennon cover, wasn't it?
Which was?
I mean, I can't remember. Oh, hang on. Jealous Guy.
Jealous Guy, 2 points. Two points for you. Ian, over to you for a clip of Chuck Berry.
Saw her from the corner when she turned a double back. Started walking toward a coffee-colored Cadillac. Pushing through the crowd, trying to get to where she's at. Campaign shouting like a Georgia Democrat. Hey, Dean, is that you? Oh, Nadine, honey, is that you?
Berry wearing one of my shirts. Can you name the label which first signed and launched Chuck Berry?
The label?
Yes.
Chess.
Chess label it was, for 1 point. For the other point, can you name his first UK top 30 hit?
Oh, no.
It's not the most likely one, actually.
Hang on. Okay.
No.
Hello? It was Carol or School Days, one of those two.
Which one are you going for?
I don't know if Carol was a hit, I think School Days.
School Days, right, yes, that was his first British hit. Two well-earned Chuck Berry points. Over to you, Dave, for some Phil Collins. Great singer, Phil Collins. That was Don't Let Him Steal Your Heart Away from his second solo album. For 1 point, can you name the Lennon McCartney song he recorded on his first solo album on Face Value?
It's from the Revolver LP, isn't it?
Yes, it is from Revolver, absolutely right. Yes. But what's the track? Anguish, pain. I'm loving it. I'm just watching it here. It's great seeing the torment.
Tomorrow Never Knows.
Tomorrow Never Knows. Well done, yes. That's 1 point. 1 point for that. I'll give you a bonus point if you can tell me the original title of Tomorrow Never Knows was going to be called. Now, John Lennon was originally going to call it The Void, and then changed it to Tomorrow Never Knows. But for your real second point, which jazz rock outfit did Phil Collins record with apart from Genesis?
Brand X.
Brand X is right. 2 points. Right, Alan, over to you, and a clip for you of the great Aretha Franklin. Great.
great Aretha Franklin.
She recorded a double live LP in church using gospel choirs. Do you know what it was called? No. A live LP in church using gospel choirs?
Probably Nearer My God to Thee.
No, it was actually also a hit for Judy Collins.
No,
it wasn't Say a Little Prayer for Me, that was a hit single.
No, it wasn't, it was Amazing Grace.
Yes.
And for a second point, or in your case for a first point, can you name the Doobie Brothers song she recorded and had a UK hit within 1980? She had a 1980 hit, big hit.
Really?
Doobie Brothers song.
I Was Abroad at the Time.
No, it wasn't that one. I Was Abroad at the Time.
But Doobie Brothers, the only one I know is that... What? No, really, I don't know it. I have to admit.
All right, What a Fool Believes.
Oh, yes, I know that
the
song.
Right. So, tragically nothing there, but finally in this round, Michael, a clip for you of the Eagles singing Doolin Dalton, followed by Desperado. Michael, can you name the Eagles' only UK top 10 hit?
One of These Nights?
No. I've got to tell you, it was Hotel California. But One of These Nights was a great guess. For the second point, can you name one member, apart from Joe Walsh, who went on to a solo career?
Don Henley.
Don Henley, yes, or Glenn Frey. So you have 1 point out of two, well done. And at the end of round five, Ian Gillan's team 15, Dave Gilmour's team 20. Oh. Okay, 10 songs coming up on the theme of Doctor. You don't have to list the songs. All you have to do is list the artists. But they're all on the same theme of doctors. Away you go, and I'll ask you how many you've got after you've seen the doctors. Let's go down to the health centre.
Everybody needs a shot of vitamin B. So come on down to my surgery.
Just put away your demon potion. Gosh, you play.
Ooh, that looked painful, didn't it? Right, 10 songs on the theme of Doctor. Right, I don't know how you did. Ian, how did you do?
Well, we'll take a shot at five of them.
You think you've got five? Dave?
We got five, too.
You got five as well. Right, Ian, do you want to give me your five?
Well, the first one we think is Dr. Feelgood. Second one, Sheila B. Devotion. Third one, we don't know. Fourth one, no idea. Fifth one, even less of an idea. The sixth one, we think could be the Beatles. The seventh, sounded like the Thompson Twins. The eighth, well, I know it's wrong. The eighth, UFO. 9 and 10, don't know.
Okay, I'll tell you how many you've got in a moment.
It's not many.
We haven't got the first one. We have Bonnie Tyler for two. I'm not very confident on that. Three, I don't know. Four, we've got Sonny. Five, we have Jackson Browne. Six, the Beatles. Seven, the Thompson Twins.
That's it?
We'll try Monkeys for nine.
Okay, a good try, but not a right try. I will tell you the answers are Dr. Feelgood down at the Doctor's, 5,000 Volts, Dr. Kiss Kiss, Dr. Love, Tina Charles, Doctor's Orders was Sonny, Jackson Browne, Dr. My Eyes, Beatles, Dr. Robert, you both got, Thompson Twins, Dr. Doctor, UFOs, Dr. Doctor, The Who, and also Dr. Doctor, which was The Other Side of Pictures of Lily. Robert Palmer's Bad Case of Loving You. So, you got four each there. Well done at the... Four each on the Doctor round, which brings us to Ian Gillan's team having 19 and Dave Gilmour's team 24. Yes, the mutterings of early days to my right. As we go to the quickfire round, things on the buses, 2 points for a right answer, 1 point if I throw it over to somebody else. Whose new single is called Blue Jean?
David Bowie.
Yes, Mike Peters?
David Bowie.
David Bowie, 2 points. Who had a hit in 76 with Jeans On? Jeans On. Dave Gilmour.
David Dundas.
David Dundas, yes, your light came up first. With which band did Ghostbuster Ray Parker first have hits? Ghostbuster Ray Parker Jr. was with which group? Anybody? Radio was the answer. Who did Jack and Jill? What was the name of Graham Parker's backing group? Yes, Dave.
The Rumour.
The Rumour, 2 points. What was Fleetwood Mac's follow-up album to Rumour? Yes, Mike.
Tusk.
Tusk, 2 points. Who is this? Who was it? Anybody? It was Rockwell. Who first recorded it? Yes, Dave.
The Beatles.
The Beatles for 2 points. Who is in the charts currently Lost in Music? Yes, Michael.
Sister Sledge.
Sister Sledge, 2 points. Who sang Knowing Me, Knowing You? Mike. Knowing Me, Knowing You. Yes, Dave.
ABBA.
ABBA, 1 point to you for ABBA. Who sang Watching Me, Watching You? Yes, Mike.
Thompson Twins.
No, well, 1 point to somebody else.
Rockwell.
That'll serve you right for screaming. No, it wasn't Rockwell, it was David Grant. Which Beatles album contained the George Harrison song, Only a Northern Song? Because it's only a Northern song, Mike.
Abbey Road.
No, it's Yellow... Yes, go on, I can't throw it ever. I said Yellow Submarine. In 68, who spent last night in Soho? Last night in Soho. I Let My Love Grow. Hands up, who spent last night in Soho? The answer is Dave D. Dersey Beaky McIntitch, who will be mortified because one of them is on the programme next week. 2 points if you can tell me which one it is. Anybody? Yes, Dave.
Dave D?
Dave D, yes. We asked the others, but they just couldn't get here. Right, according to Billy Fury in 62, what was last night made for? Yes, Dave.
Love?
Love, it was. Last night was made for love. No screaming, please. Young Guns, Go For It was their first hit. What was their last, Maggie?
Oh. I don't know.
Gamesmanship. Mike, 2 points if you can tell me.
Wake me up before you go-go.
Wake me up before you go-go. Yes, we can't have these games, but you press the button and pretend you know. Who was going to a go-go in 66? Yes, Dave.
Smokey Robinson.
Smokey Robinson and the Miracles. For another 2 points, can you tell me Alice Cooper's real name? Yes, Dave.
Vince Furnier.
Vince Furnier. What did his father do? Anybody? His father?
Preacher.
Preacher. Michael Mullins?
Yeah, preacher.
Yes, he was a preacher. 2 points. Deary me. Which brother and sister sang a duet called Deep Purple? Yes, Mike.
Marie and Donny Osmond.
Marie and Donny Osmond, absolutely right. You can hear the screams for Donny from here. Final question, who is this?
What number is this, Jim?
7A.
Yes, Mike.
Monkeys.
The Monkeys and Dave Jim Believer, well done. I was going to say that David Jones is on next week's show if you give me a chance. Right, so at the end of tonight's contest, Ian Gillan's team 30, Dave Gilmour's team 39. They're all friends, really. We'll be buying drinks afterwards and pouring them over each other. Let's say goodnight to the team that came second, and they are from The Alarm, Mike Peters. And all the way from Geordieland, Alan Price. and the skipper, Ian Gillan. And as the two captains are back for their fourth time each, it's got to be a moral victory, certainly for Dave Gilmour's team, who are Maggie from Swansway, Michael Mullins from Modern Romance, and the victorious skipper, Dave Gilmour. So, on next week's teams, we have John Entwistle from The Who, Fergal Sharkey, and Davy Jones from The Monkees, playing against Dave D from Dozy, Beaky, Mick and Titch, Tony Butler from Big Country, and Cheryl Baker from Bucks Fizz. And by popular demand, we're going to leave you with that legendary Andover ensemble, led by the one and only inimitable Reg Presley, the Troggs, and here is Reg singing Into an Electric Shaver on Wild Thing.
But I wanna know for sure.